Can you talk now?
Okay, I'm on your house now.
Okay. Okay. Let me know when you're ready.
Okay.
Okay.
What?
Yes, I can hear you.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So So Ruby, you found me on YouTube.
YouTube, okay.
No, I meant Facebook. You found me on Facebook.
Okay, I do one I met you on your Facebook.
Okay.
I could send the view that I have. So.
Okay. So what is it that you're expecting the Lord to do in your life today?
Actually, I didn't change because I saw that things are not moving just the way I think it should be. So I'm just seeing myself going down more and more. I don't know. So
like
I'm not working. I'm working.
Oh. Okay, so you see yourself going. You say you see yourself going down and down.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Okay. Now, Ruben, let me ask you: Are you living with a woman?
Yes, I am. The person I proposed to marry. The first person that left me is the one that made. I'm thinking that this person is the one that made me to that young into this condition now. I think.
Okay.
But this one is just prayerful. So.
Okay. Now, my question is, are you living with her? Are you two living in the same house?
Yes, I live with her.
Now, are you two considered to be married? Have you had the marriage ceremony? Have you had a marriage ceremony?
Yeah, I've not done anything, but I have seen the parents, and I think I discussed about them. I'm coming back, but since I said I'm coming back, I could not even make it again to go back.
Okay, let me understand this clearly now. Now, you are married to the lady that you are living with.
Yeah, actually, I've seen the parents, but I've not done everything that it takes to make it as a wife. So. I told him that I'm coming to clear everything, but coming back, I found out that things are going down more and more.
Okay, because I know the customs in Africa as far as marriage is different than the custom here. So my question is, the young lady that you're living with, are you married to her? Mm. Not promised in marriage, but are you married?
Actually, I'm married to her. Actually, you know, in a way that I have to do some rites traditionally, and I will take her to altar. But I'm in the process of doing the traditional rites. I found myself being financially down, you know, to meet up with demand. So,
mm-hmm.
So that is,
because in all of
so
In order for the Lord to bless you, Reuben, you have to be married. Now, I'm not just talking about you. You living with her until you're able to get the dowry, and then you marry. That's a sin. You must be married to her if you're living with her. And if you're not married to her and you're living with her, then God cannot bless you. Everything will go down because you are committing fornication because you're not married. Are you understanding? Are you understanding?
Okay. I should believe. Why I'm not going down because I'm not dead directly. Is that?
So are you telling me that you don't have the marriage in writing?
Yes, actually, I was ready to do the things I wanted to do. I prepared to do that when I have the first person. In the process of doing the thing I wanted to do, the person dropped out. So with that, with that condition, I have to switch over to the person and I pray that God should give me another person. And this is coming, but when I get there, I found out that things was good. Well, actually, my God tell me this is the right person. Usually, I found out the person believes in Christ. Well, so on the move, they have a right. After seeing the parents, you have to say notes to see yourself whether you can align. So in the process of that, I have to go on my way planning to come back. I found out that things blocked. So the energy for me to go back there wasn't there. Available. So I'm thinking every month I receive a family, things that will take them out. I don't know how it comes, so I don't know. So and she herself is even serious in prayers in a way to get this healed.
You know, because about a month or so ago, I was talking with this pastor who's from Africa. And he was sharing with me that there are a lot of Native Africans who are living with a man, living with a woman, and they never married, but they've been together so long that they consider themselves to be married. And that's sin in God's eyesight, Reuben. That is sin. And anytime sin is present, it hinders the blessings of God. See, you can't live with a woman and you're not married to her, but you hoping to be married or there's a promise to be married because you have not gotten the money for the dowry, but you're still living together and you having sex together. That's sin. That's sin in the eyes of God. That still makes you a fornicator. And Lord said, no fornicator shall inherit the kingdom of God.
Okay.
And by doing that again, it's gonna hinder your blessing. Satan's gonna hinder your blessing because you are living in sin. It would have been best if you had never moved in with this woman, never allow this woman to move in with you because you two were not married. Joseph and Mary was espoused to one another. There was a promise of marriage, but they did not come together and live together until they were married. When they was married, that's when Mary went in Joseph's house. She didn't go in his house before that, before she married him. She didn't go in his house because they was espoused or promised to be married. She did not do that because they knew that's a sin. Now, do you have any children by this woman? Do you two have any children?
It's a child now.
Another child now. So let me see if I'm understanding this correctly, because there's a noise that's kind of interfering with me understanding you clearly. So are you telling me that there was another young lady in which you was wanted to marry, and she wanted to marry you?
Yes.
But she kind of put herself on you where you two had sex before marriage, and then she changed her mind about marrying you.
Yeah, actually, in the process of trying to, I have made the right things, no way to have her, and interrupted because it's saw somebody coming from the U.S. Maybe you found out that place, you definitely can be willing to make her to travel further, in terms of having an experience of a different country, all that. So, no, I was not feeling bad because of that, because maybe I believe that God will move a heavy load out of me. So, but you see, the person who cares, I mean, who wants me to be together. So, I low down and just say, let me look at her. I pray that God say, yes, you go ahead. But on the process of going, I found myself going down more and more. You know, I don't know whether it's a terror taking me down or what. So,
okay.
That's all about that.
So, as of today, whoever this girl was, you two are no longer together. You with another woman now, and you and this woman, have a child.
Yeah.
Okay. So what you're saying is you are very unhappy. You are very unhappy in that relationship.
Yeah.
Because the
enemy, you're very unhappy.
I sense you're very unhappy. All because the enemy is telling you you should have married the first girl. That was the promised girl. But I'm here to tell you, she was not the promised girl. Because the devil threw this girl, entice you and force you to sin against God. So you know, your happiness is not wrapped up or tied up in this in being with this girl. That's just a lie that the enemy is telling you, that you will be much happier. You'll be much happier if you connect with this girl. That is a lie of the devil. The devil wants to put you further and deeper into sin. Now, Ruben, what you should do, this is what you should do. You should marry the woman that you will, that you have the child by. You should marry her. This is what you should do.
I am ready to do that now. But whenever I am planning to do this, I tell you that since I will take away money, I don't know. Before you know it, I will be out of cash. I don't know. So I'm feeling it. I don't know why. This time around, because before I don't find myself in this condition. So now I'm seeing myself as somebody who could have money on his hand. I don't know.
Who's stopping you from marrying her is that spirit wife. You have a spirit wife. You have a spirit wife that is hindering you from marrying her. This spirit wife is hindering you from marrying her, and it's whispering you that you would be much happier if you was to leave and go find this other woman. And that's not true. No, it's the spirit wife that is hindering hindering you from marrying her. Okay, but God is going to set you free, Reuben. He's going to set you free. Understand? He's going to free you. But I'm going to tell you what you have to do. You cannot have sex with this woman because she's not your wife. You understand what I'm saying? You can no longer have sex with the woman that you're living with because she's not your wife. After God set you free. After God set you free, you need to quickly marry her. Go ahead and marry her. But until you marry her, you cannot have sex with her because she's not your wife. You can no longer have sex with her until she's your legal wife. Understand? And you need to explain this to her because she needs to be delivered too from that spirit husband in her. Understand what I'm saying?
I understand.
You understand what I'm saying? She needs to be delivered from the spirit husband that is in her. Okay? So what I'm going to do now, Reuben, I'm going to pray for you, and by faith, I'm going to speak a disconnection, and God's going to deliver you from that spirit wife and every spirit that's not of him, and you will be completely free. Your will be free then to choose to marry this girl, this woman that you are in the house with. And also, you cannot you cannot have sex with her until she become your legal wife. And you explain it to her, and she needs to be delivered. Refer me to her, that she also contact me to get delivered. So you two can come together in unity of the Holy Spirit and raise your child in the Lord, in the right and proper way.
Okay.
Because if you don't, your child now do you have a little boy?
A girl.
A girl? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So she needs to see the proper way of God's word coming through you and her mother. You two just need to be married. So you can give her that example, because you don't want her to grow up and think that it's okay for her to live with a man that is not her husband. Because she would do that because she would see her parents have done that. And you don't want that to happen. Okay, so I'm going to pray for you and speak a disconnection. All right? All right. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and pray now. So, Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for giving me again this opportunity to minister grace and mercy to your son, Reuben. I thank you, Father, that every plan, every purpose, every idea that you have for him, it shall come to pass in Jesus' mighty name. Father, I ask you to give him more revelation of who he is in you and also who you are in him. Open his spiritual eyes to see truth, his clouded ears to hear truth, Father. Father, I thank you that every door that the enemy has sealed off from him, in the name of Jesus, and it's your will to be open in Jesus' name, I open those doors. And every door that the enemy, every door that the enemy have opened, Father, and it's not your will to be open, I also close those doors in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I ask you not just to work in Reuben's mind, but in the young lady's mind, Lord. And I thank you, Lord, for working her mind and convicting her of sin, of righteousness and judgment as you done Reuben, Father. Father, you said, whosoever the two join together, let no man separate or put asunder. And I thank you, Father, for keeping this family together. Father, thank you, Father, for putting them first on the right track, Father, in order to bring you glory on this earth. Father, we thank you for your presence because you said where there are two or three gathered in your son's name, you are here with us, and whatever we bind and loose on this earth, Father, you will bind and you will loose in the heavens. So I take authority in the name of Jesus, and I command you, wife, to pack your load and for you to get out of God's house. You get out of his mind, you get out of his will, you get out of his emotions, and you get out of his body now in the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, Holy Ghost fire burn, Holy Spirit burn all manner of darkness and evil that's lurking and hiding dormantly in his mind. Burn, Holy Spirit, burn in his mind, set his mind ablaze of all darkness that lifts up the knowledge of Jesus Christ. Burn, Holy Spirit, in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, celebrate all manner of darkness that's lurking and hiding dormantly in his emotions. Burn, Holy Spirit, burn in Jesus' mighty name. Burn darkness in his emotions. Burn everything that exalts itself against the knowledge of God in his emotions. Burn, Holy Spirit, burn in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire continues to set ablaze his will, search and destroy all manner of darkness that's lurking and hiding dormantly in his will. Burn, Holy Spirit, set ablaze, burn everything in this will that exalts itself against the knowledge of God. Burn, Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus, burn. Holy Ghost, fire, set ablaze his body. Burn all manner of darkness that's lurking and hiding dormantly in his body. Holy Ghost, fire, burn in his body. Burn, burn in his belly. Burn all manner of snakes and eggs that's laying dormantly in his belly. Burn in his private area. Burn in his mouth, in his nose, in his ears. Burn everywhere on his body that have been placed a mark, known or unknown to him. Burn, Holy Spirit, burn everywhere on his body that a hole had been pierced illegally in the name of Jesus. Burn, Holy Spirit, set his body ablaze from the crown of his head to the soles of his feet. Burn, Holy Spirit, burn, give him a complete session, a complete washing by your fire. In the name of Jesus, I take the scissors of God and I cut and detach him from that family of idolatry and witchcraft, from that family of bigotry in the name of Jesus, polygotry in the name of Jesus. Burn, Holy Spirit, I disconnect him from that evil spirit marriage, evil spirit children, evil spirit family, spirit wife. I disconnect him in the spirit realm by the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I disconnect him from every relationship in the spirit realm that the Father did not connect him to. I disconnect him even in this natural realm from every relationship that the Father did not connect him to. I disconnect, destroy that the root in the mighty name of Jesus, for the blood of Jesus detaches him from every relationship that he did not connect him to in the mighty name of Jesus. Brother Reuben, in the name of Jesus, you be free in your mind. You be free in your mind. You be free in your mind. You be free in your will. You be free in your emotions. You be free in your body to serve and worship the Lord thy God. And him only will you serve in spirit and truth. Be free in Jesus' mighty name. Father, I ask you to your brother. Fill his body. Fill his emotion. Fill his body with your spirit, Father, in Jesus' name. Father, I now pray for Reuben's house. Holy Ghost, fire, go search and destroy at his house. All manner of darkness, and running and hiding. Go in every room, every corner, crack, and crevice of the room. Go under every chair, under every bed, over and around. Burn darkness, burn, burn, burn. Set ablaze darkness in every area, even go outside of his home. Burn around the home, under the home, even under the ground. Objects that was planted under the ground. Burn, Holy Spirit, burn those objects in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for sending your spirit, dear Father, to convict the woman of sin, judgment, and righteousness, Father. I thank you, Father, because you are a I thank you, Father, for keeping them to the day of redemption, Father. Because again, Father, every plan, purpose, and idea you have for them, it shall take place in Jesus' name. I thank you, Father. Making your way straight to him, Father. Open the doors that you desire to open. Closing those doors that Satan have opened, Father.
Amen.
Praise you and thank you in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Forgive him, Reuben. Go and sin no more.
Amen.
Now, Brother Reuben, you are free. Now, remember now what the Lord said. You're not married to her. A promise of marriage is not marriage, the Lord said. So you cannot have sexual relations with her because she's not your wife. You have to wait until you're married. And you share the good news that God has told you, you share it with her. And you two marry. You two quickly marry. So you can set that godly example before your child. Because that spirit wife, as well as that spirit husband in her, was hindering your blessing. That spirit no longer needs you, but that spirit husband is in her. And don't be surprised tonight that thing show up in your dream. And also, Brother Reuben, you cannot sleep in the same bed with her because she's not your wife. The Lord told me to tell you, you cannot sleep in the same bed with her until she is your wife. You understand what I'm saying? You understand, Brother Reuben?
Excuse me?
I said, did you understand what I said?
I don't understand.
I said, the Lord said you cannot sleep in the same bed with her until she is your wife. You understand that?
Yes, ma'am.
You cannot act as though she's your wife if you legally you have not married. Being promised to marry is not being married. Being promised to marry, Mary was promised in marriage to Joseph. Scripture tells they didn't come and live together until they got married about a year later. They got married. So just because you promised to marry doesn't mean that you are married. That's not a marriage. And since you're not married, you cannot sleep in the same bed because that's not your wife. And you cannot be undressing yourself around her, or she cannot be undressing herself around you because you're not married. You have to treat her mm-hmm. as though she's a strange woman, and she must treat you as though you're a strange man because you're not married. Now, because of your circumstances, you have to continue to be in the same house because of your circumstances. Mm-hmm. So you share this truth with her, and you quickly marry, and then you can do as married people do, and you can act as married people act. That's if you want the blessings of God, now, Brother Reuben. This is what, if you want the blessings mm-hmm. of God. Being in disobedience to God, you're not going to receive his blessings.
Mm-hmm.
Understand? Mm-hmm. So Brother Reuben, as I was praying the fire prayer, what was going on with you? What was you experiencing as I was praying?
Mm-hmm.
I said, as I was praying, mm-hmm. what was you experiencing as I was praying? What was going on with you as I was praying?
Hello. Come again, mommy.
Huh?
Hello, mommy. Come again.
Can you hear me?
Okay, come again, please, ma'am.
I said, as I was praying. What was you doing, or what was you experiencing as I was praying?
Okay, I was in spirit, actually. I was in spirit. Yeah. And I observed all things you said. I believe that is exactly what the point you made. So I think I chose what you said, because I will continue on prayer so that I can meet up the demands.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, praise the Lord.
I was in touch.
So the main thing what you do, this truth that God has spoken to you, Brother Reuben, you also speak it to the young lady, okay? Because like I said, pastor that I ministered deliverance to, I think about a month or so ago, he's originally from Cameroon, but he's living in Germany. And and the Lord brought that up as far as people living together, been living together for so long that they begin to act and think that they're married. And people outside don't realize that they're not married. They really think that they married. And he was telling me that there's a lot of Native Africans who does that. You know, they've been living together for many, many years, that they feel like that they're married and they never marry, and people think they're married and they think they're married when in truth they are not married. And according to the word of God, they are a fornicator. That's why the Lord said an adulterer, not just an adulterer, but a fornicator will not inherit the kingdom of God. Why? Because there are people who actually have been living with a man, living with a woman all for many, many years, and they die. And when they died, they go to hell because they died a fornicator. As a matter of truth, my stepfather, his father, he became sick, and this woman, which we thought was his wife, was with him for 40 years. She was with him for 40 years, and we all thought they was married until my stepfather said they had never married. They had never married. And same thing happened to this man who was in the church. Him and this woman, we thought that they was married, had grown children, had grandchildren, and he died.
Wonderful.
And so she went to try to collect his benefit. She couldn't, because everybody found out they had never married. And everybody thought they was married. Now, you think that man is in the kingdom of heaven? No. He died a fornicator. And that's sad.
Well,
that's sad.
I understood.
Yeah, a promise in marriage is not the same as being married. Being married.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we have to do what is right in the eyes of God in order to be blessed. When we do wrong, Reuben, that opens the door for the enemy to torment us and take our blessings away. regardless how much we go to church, sing and appear that we are righteous and holy, and we know that the woman or the man that we with and sleeping with, raising a family with, is legally not our husband, legally not our wife, God is not going to bless us. You know, your pastor may bless you, but Jesus is not going to bless you. You want to get things right with God. Get things right with God. Things right with
God. I will do that.
And then when you get things right with him, then you say, you know, whatever young lady name is, say, look, you know, we need to get right with God. We need to marry.
Excellent.
We need to marry. Yeah. And you marry.
Yeah,
you marry. And then God can bless that union. Then God can bless whatever you put your hands to do. Then God can help you. He can help you. But sin prevents him from helping you. Sin prevents him from helping you. Okay? So praise the living God. He loves us so much, Reuben, and he don't want nothing to come between us and him. He loves
us.
Praise his whole name. So you share this truth with that young man. And you two do whatever it takes to go ahead and get married. Because what's important is not to please your family members, but to please God. To please God. Yeah. That is what's important. To please God. And a lot of times pleasing God may cause us to displease our family members. No, your aim and her aim is to please God. It's to please God. Praise God. So Brother Reuben, you know, and if you have any more questions, just feel free to send me a message on Facebook, and as soon as I can, I will answer your question, okay?
Okay. I'll give in touch with you. Any development, I will link you back to your line.
Okay. Now let me ask you, what part of Nigeria are you in?
I'm in FCT, Abuja.
Abuja. Okay.
Abuja, the capital.
Yeah, Abuja. Okay. Praise the Lord. You know.
Thank you.
Amen. All right. Now you continue to stay blessed. Okay. And obey the Lord's word that he has given you, okay?
Oh, thank you, Mom.
All right, then. Bye-bye.
God bless
you. You too. Bye.
God bless you.